Last weekend on The X Factor, the competition was explosive.
It was Night of the Living Dead.
Adore you. You totally won me over.
You're not a real rocker. Don't know what you're talking about.
Shut up, you two.
And another dream was shattered.
The act that will be leaving the competition tonight, Rachel.
This week, it's movie week. And as the finalists hit the red carpet, the pressure is really on.
This is the dream.
The eight remaining acts battling for your vote. Danny and the girls. Stacey Solomon and Lucy Jones.
I lost my first girl last week and there's no way that's going to happen again.
Cheryl and the boys. Lloyd Daniels and Joe McKeldry.
I'm very protective of my boys and I want them to go as far as they can and I think that they deserve it.
Louis and the last of the groups, John and Edward.
Simon said he would leave the country if John and Edward win the competition. Don't forget to send a postcard, Simon.
And Simon and the over 25s, Ollie Merce, Jamie Archer and Daniel Johnson.
I'm still the only judge with three acts. I'm obviously getting it right. And they are the three you've got to be.
It's time.
Tonight's going to be a big night and some of these songs are really tough.
To face.
Are the other three judges scared of me? Yes. And rightly so.
The music.
If you think you've seen it all, you haven't. You're in for a treat tonight.
Remain. There's no respite for them tonight. We are hitting them with a blockbuster of a theme. It's movie night.
Yes! Yes, it is.
They're going to be singing songs from big, famous movies. Everything from Pulp Fiction to Ghostbusters. But who will be a box office smash and who will be a complete turkey? Well, there's four people who's going to be telling them straight. Four people who need those special effects to make them truly terrifying. Four people who are locked in their own version of Star Wars. It's the X Factor judges.
Louis, Danny, Cheryl, and Simon.
Judges are in place, or getting in place. It is time for action. Always so much at stake. Every act tonight, of course, singing live and fighting to keep their place in the competition. First into the fray, it's the girls. So we go to their mentor, our very own screen siren, Danny Minogue.
Thank you. Stacey Solomon. Song choice for you.
Stacey.
I was really happy with how I performed last weekend.
I thought it was terrific.
Finally. I'm not one of the over 25s and he likes me.
Stacey proved that she belonged on that stage and it was fantastic to see.
It
This week we're about to go to the world premiere of Disney's Christmas Carol.
I'm so excited. I just can't wait to get out of the car.
I never ever thought I'd be on the red carpet.
This is what you dream about, and here I am, yeah. It happened.
If I was lucky enough to win the competition, I might get to go to premieres all the time.
This week is movie week, and the song that I've chosen for Stacey is from Pulp Fiction.
I didn't watch Pulp Fiction till this week.
It was a bit violent. It wouldn't have been in one of my DVD collections at home. I'm more of a Toy Story girl myself.
The song that Stacey's singing tonight, it's an all-time classic, and it's a very sexy song.
I'm a little bit worried about the song because you have to be, like, quite sexy when you perform it. I just get embarrassed.
Stacey's not a natural mover. I basically had her copy me in the mirror until it looked like she was actually doing the right steps.
Everything should look like it's your move.
It's about being confident. It's about being sexy.
Stacey's adorable, but I don't think it's in her to be sexy.
I'm not worried. I've got total faith in Stacey because she's just getting better and better.
I really hope that tonight on stage I can put all the emotion in it and just be sexy.
Springfield, and I love your new sexy look. You've definitely got the personality, girl, for this competition. Absolutely. And if it was based on personality, you would absolutely walk it. However, I did think the song lacked a little bit of emotion. I really...
Do you know what, Stacey? It's lovely to say you're looking so sexy and young and a young girl, and I thought that was your most confident looking performance you've done so far.
I'm going to disagree with Cheryl. Because I would call that a typical talent show competition, in so much as eating Chinese food, you don't really feel anything afterwards. You still feel hungry.
Good.
What?
I felt good.
Okay.
Do
see, you always feel good. But I just don't think that was a particularly good performance. I thought it was a lazy song choice. And I think for the first time since you've been in this competition, I think you were vulnerable after that.
I do. To say is it shows how out of touch Simon Cowell is. The best reaction you've had from the audience. I know people at home will love it. I know you've had a problem with the word sexy. You can't even say it. You're flirty, you're fun, you're young. It's everything the song should be. You've got the authentic tones in your voice of Dusty Springfield. It's cool. It's what Duffy and Amy would have done. Thank you. It was brilliant.
All right, thank you, judges. Feisty mood tonight, like this. Listen, you. Yeah, Olivia Newton-John coming down here. I loved it. And did you feel that was a sexy performance?
Oh, it was sexy, but...
The audience, I think, find you quite sexy as well. Even though most of you are girls. Which is wonderful. 0901 61 61 101, number to call if you want Stacey to take another starring role in next week's show. Sky and Virgin Media viewers can vote using a red button, but don't do it now. The lines won't open until all eight acts have performed. Calls cost 35p from a BT landline, from other networks, maybe higher from mobiles, will be considerably more. Votes cast before the opening time won't be counted, but may still be charged. Kicking us off tonight, everyone, is Stacey Solomon. Enjoys herself. Coming up, we are taking bets to see if Ollie's going to keep his clothes on this week. And he found himself in the bottom two last week. Find out if Lloyd fights back. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back to The X Factor. We are celebrating songs from the movies. Up next, the over 25. So we go to a resident villain, Dr. Evil, if you will, Mr. Simon Cowell.
Starting off my category, it's the incredible Ollie Murs.
You're the one artist that gets better every time we see
you. I absolutely adore you.
Ollie. Saturday night was the best performance I think I've given so far. Every week I'm just feeling much more confident, ripping my shirt open. I've not got like Peter Andre Peck, so I think it just felt right in the soul. I can't even describe why I did it. This week we went to a premiere for Disney's new film, which is The Christmas Carol. I completely felt like a celebrity.
I love it. I mean, this is what dreams are made of, and it's so tough to be here.
To see all the fans screaming your names, and the paparazzi wanting pictures of you, I mean, with so many flashes of light, I just didn't know what I was doing most of the time. It's just made me more determined to do well in this competition and really chase my dream. And so the next time I go over the red carpet, that, you know, I am a pop star.
With Ollie this week, I've chosen the song from Ferris Bueller's Day Off. This movie is one of my favourite movies of all time. Ferris in the movie, he's funny, he's cheeky, just made me think of Ollie.
I've watched this film since I was little, and the scene where he sings this song is such an iconic moment in the film. Although I do really love this song, I'm really worried that I'm not going to make it my own.
It's such an old song, and what I want to do is make it more contemporary and more modern.
Simon's choosing the same kind of tracks for Ollie week in and week out.
We want to see more versatility.
I love this song, I love this scene, and I just can't wait to see it live.
I completely trust Simon's judgment. He sees a vision for this song. I know I've just got to go out there and I've just got to make the song my own.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, baby, now.
You are definitely one of the strongest contenders in the competition. But I like to hear you singing. I wasn't crazy about the silly dancing, if I'm really honest. But Ollie, I'm not blaming you. I think Simon picked a really, really silly song for a great, great singer. I think you're much better than this. I think you're much better. Simon, why the silly song? Why?
Ollie, I don't know if you sang beautifully, great performance. There's something that looks like you didn't believe in the song. I don't know what it is.
Yes, I agree.
Then why did it go into Michael Jackson's thriller routine halfway through? I don't know. But if you haven't seen that movie, that did look random.
But it's in the movie.
But if you haven't seen the movie, you wouldn't know why he's doing the thriller.
Well, watch the movie.
Well, anyways, Ollie, you only have to listen. But you are singing a lot of retro songs. Only one thing I want to do now is hear you singing something contemporary.
Unfortunately, guys, the audience is speaking. And as for your comment, Louis, about this being a silly song, it's one of the Beatles' biggest hits. I honestly think where all of you have been quite mean tonight is that he put on a great show. Right, it's called entertainment.
Yeah, but so
and Ollie, that's fantastic.
Guys, let's hear from Ollie, okay? Ollie, apart from probably wanting to run for Prime Minister at the moment, thoughts on the comments? Because obviously, you know, the judges are giving you quite a mixed bag. Obviously, Simon's very supportive, but...
No, I mean, I really like the song, and I take all the judges' comments on board, and obviously I'll strive to hopefully get in next week and do the best I can.
Would you want to make it more contemporary, do you think, or are you quite happy doing a lot of the, you know, the classics?
I'm just happy with the judgment. Simon gives me great songs, and I'm just happy to do them, and I'm really happy either way. I try to make it my own with a bit of my style on it, and hopefully it works, so...
Nice one, Ollie. Thanks a million. 0901 61 61 102. Call that number to ensure that Ollie is back here shaking his hips and looking suggestively at dancers next week. Lines open at the end of the show, so wait till then. For now, it's Ollie Mears, everyone. Tough week for the boys last week. Let's see if they're raring to go with their mentor, Cheryl Cole. Cheryl, who's up first for you?
1st of May, boys. It's the lovely Lloyd Daniels. Every one of your female fans wishes that was sung about them.
You're going to have to start singing better if you want to stay in the competition.
It's Rachel against Lloyd in the final showdown.
I want the public to decide on this one.
Rachel.
When I found out I was in the bottom two, I just felt a bit like rubbish, actually.
And then on top of that, I had a really sore throat on Sunday, so it was really tough for me to sing my song for survival.
Seeing Lloyd in the bottom two last week was heartbreaking, but he's back, he's well, and he's ready to fight again tonight.
This week, we all went to the world premiere of a Disney's A Christmas Carol. From the second I stepped out of that car, I can't explain. I just felt amazing. There were so many flashes just going off in my face. I felt like a complete film star. Look at this! It was a taste of what my life could be like, and I won that.
I'm really happy with our song choice this week. I've chosen a perfect song for Lloyd from the movie Stand By Me.
I saw Stand By Me a couple of months before the competition, and I absolutely loved it. It's an all-time classic film from the 80s. I just thought it was great that like four friends get together and just go on a journey, and I got to relate to that. I love the facts about friendship, and I can't wait to sing a song from it.
All Cheryl's going to do is choose a current movie and a current song, and she'll get it right with Lloyd.
This song is quite an old song, but what we've done tonight has made it more contemporary.
I think this song is all wrong for Lloyd. It's too old. He's going to be in the bottom two again.
Now my throat's better. I feel like I got my spark back. And nothing's going to stop me from fighting for this.
Lloyd Daniels!
Mm-hmm.
has come, and the land is dark, and the moon is the only light we'll see. No, I won't be afraid. No, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand, stand by.
And 3 weeks ago, you were like the cute kid in the competition. But at this stage in the competition, Lloyd, I think you're out of your depth because I don't think you're good enough. I think there are four better guy singers than you in the competition. Four guys better than you. Out of your depth. Sorry.
Lloyd, you're a very, very cute guy. It was a very cute performance. I thought vocally that was well chosen for you because there's a certain range that you can sing in and you can't go above that. It lost it a little bit when you came off the high note. I think you got so excited you got there and you kind of missed the tuning on it.
Yeah.
It was a nice performance.
Yeah, nice, like having tea with your mum. But look, the problem is, which by the way, I like doing. I mean, I do like mum. Love it. Love it. But the point is, Lloyd, is that I think right now, you, I'm in so much trouble, you're out of your depth, to be honest with you. You are. You're competing against some big, big singers, and it kind of feels to me that you're giving up a little bit at the moment. And the second part of the song, where it went young, which was more your age group, it worked okay, but, you know, your voice wasn't big enough for the song. That's the problem.
Look, because obviously, yeah, he's come back. He's in the bottom two last week. He had a tough time of it. So, yes, he is, you know, down on his confidence. That's normal. He's had a knock. But I thought it was your most comfortable vocal you've done so far. We did make it young. It was funky. It was cool. And if I had took it to a younger movie, I would have made you cheesy, and I don't want to make you cheesy because I think you're cooler
Cheryl,
than that.
There are four better singers in the competition.
Thank you very much, Cheryl. Guys, talk about kick a guy when he's down. I mean, like, in terms of your confidence, how do you feel sort of after last week?
Last week was terrible, and like, I don't know, trying to get yourself back up there after it is really hard. So I do respect your comments, but
do you think on that performance, buddy, do you think you've done enough tonight?
I hope so. I really do.
All right. Thank you very much, Lloyd. No, it's a tough time for you. 0901, 61, 61. 103. That's the number when lines open at the end of the show. If you don't want Lloyd to make his second week in the final showdown. For now, everyone, this is Lloyd Daniels. Wow. Coming up and hoping for Oscar-winning performances tonight, we have Daniel, Joe, Lucy, John and Edward and Jamie. Book your seat on this sofa right now. Hello and welcome back to the X Factor Live Finals. The finalists are singing songs from some of the biggest movies of all time. And if you fancy yourself as a critic, you can rant and rave and get vocal online by joining the chat live, itv.com/X Factor. All right, 3 over 25 still left in the competition. And the man who never tires of telling us that is Simon.
Second of my acts, still one more to come, it's Jamie Archer. Yeah!
You're an amazing performer and singer.
It wasn't authentic.
You don't know what you're talking about.
I've seen this a million times
Where?
Before.
Jamie.
Last week was a tough week for me, obviously, being Rock Week. There was a lot of expectation.
There's nothing original about you.
Him saying that I'm not original isn't true. Makes me disappointed that I'm not fulfilling my potential.
This is nothing more than mind games. You were terrific tonight.
The first time since I started competition, I actually feel like I might be a bit famous now, and it's great.
You know it.
I always dream of walking down the red carpet and having the press pen and they're all taking photos of you. We all dream about it.
I'm back in Jamie Archer for the X Factor.
There were fans there, they wanted autographs and pictures. My God, it was great. I was in soundcheck this week. I went through my song that we'd chosen, which was Unchained Melody from the film Ghost.
It's not working, Jamie.
My heart dropped a bit because it was like, not again.
This is a constant theme with me and Jamie. We keep changing the songs.
Simon has changed Jamie's song again. This is not fair.
We've let him go back to what he wanted to do.
Crying was the original song that I suggested. It's one of my favourite songs.
The movie's called Gummo. It's not very well known, I admit, but it's still a movie.
So Simon is bending the rules again for his act. Who has heard of Gummo?
I don't care if two people have seen a movie. It's still a movie.
Even before I entered the show, I dreamed of being able to perform this particular song. In a way, you know, every cloud has a silver lining.
This is Jamie literally from the heart. I think he's going to be incredible.
Jamie Archer!
Because the song absolutely did you. But I have Simon, I don't know the movie it's from, and I think you're cheating again. I don't know the movie. What is the movie? Who was in it? Where did it come from?
Louis,
Simon, seriously.
The theme was not movies you watch at home. It's basically movies. Gummo is a movie.
I never this heard of it.
Doesn't matter. It's a cult movie.
I never heard of
and
the movie.
And apart from anything else, it's not about the film. It's about the song he sung.
But we all pick songs from big movies, Simon. We all stuck to the rules. I love the song, but I think you're cheating.
Of course.
Jeremy, you know what? It was emotional performance, it was heartfelt, and it was not the pub rocker, and this is what we were saying last week. That's what we want to see. So maybe you need to choose the songs, right? I have to say, I think Simon did you well changing the song, because I think Unchained Melody would have been absolutely disastrous for you. The song's cheesy, in my opinion, and I think that song suited you beautifully. I think you sang it from your heart, Jamie.
Thank you. Just to be clear, the version which we were basing it on was the version you two had did, and I don't think they're cheesy. I have to...
that song?
Unchained Melody, sweetheart. Oh. Look on YouTube. Jamie, but I have to say... This is all about you.
I was nice to him, by the way.
I know. Well, then don't call it the song cheesy. I was just trying to defend the original song. Anyway, it's irrelevant. Jamie, you chose that song. This performance was all about you. It was your best performance by a mile. Congratulations.
All right. First things first. Louis, you know that Simon has always been a champion of independent cinema. I mean, we all know that, right? From 1997.
Dermot, I thought he was absolutely great, but I think Simon cheated because I never heard of the movie.
Listen, let's come to you. How do you feel about those comments? Because, buddy, all this kind of, you know, changing your song and stuff, I can tell it really takes it out of you. Looking exhausted.
It's crazy. It was also in Mulholland Drive as well. I just want to say something. I want to thank everyone out there who's voted for me and supported me, because it's hard work. Thank you so much. That's all I have to say. Thank you.
Thanks, Jamie. 0901-6160-104 is Jamie's number, the one that will keep him alive and kicking in this competition. Quarter one lines open at the end of the show. It's Jamie Archer. He is knackered. After the break, she made Simon take back his words last week. Lucy will be in the stage and is having the thrills and spills of an action movie, but it's still here and it's still fighting. Daniel is here. Don't miss a second. See you in a minute. Welcome back to Movie Night here at the X Factor with Songs from the Silver Screen. I'm next and hoping for rave reviews for the girls again and Danny.
This is I Love Lucy.
Gave it 100%.
I thought you did a great job.
Lucy.
The reason I didn't like you last week was because you were boring. Tonight, I take that back.
When Simon said that he was pleased, I was like, woohoo! Finally!
Lucy definitely found her direction last week. It was young, cool, and it really suited her.
The premiere of Christmas Carol was just the best thing ever. It was so cool and I was so excited. Going to the premiere inspired me to go out and give it my best every weekend.
This week Lucy's singing a song from the film Camp Rock.
That's the song. So that must be the girl. You think?
This song is about a young girl with dreams of becoming a huge star. This could have been written for Lucy.
I love this film, and this song means so much to me that I hope people get it.
If you're saying that this song tells the story of Lucy Jones, then you need to show people that.
Yeah. The challenge for Lucy has been to get her to come out on the stage as Lucy Jones and not as another character.
I'm a little bit worried that for the first time I'm going out on stage and being myself.
If she doesn't get that connection with the audience, this song could really fall flat.
Lucy basically has to tell everybody tonight who she is, because I don't think anyone's got a clue.
Tonight I'm showing exactly who I truly am, and I just hope that's enough because I don't want to go home.
Lucy Jones!
I've always been the kind of girl to hide my face, so afraid to tell the world what I've got to say. But I have this dream right inside of me. I'm gonna let it show. It's time to let you know, to let you know.
Fantastic song choice. Not very obvious, not an obvious song, but very cool, very contemporary. You look like a pop star, and you remind me of one of these American girls like Taylor Swift or Kelly Clarkson. I predict that you're going to be the last girl standing in this competition. You've got star quality, miss.
I think you've found your niche, and this is you. I wasn't familiar with the song choice at all, but it could have been your song from the way you made it. I think there's one thing I would say is you just need to loosen up now, let it be, and enjoy it a little bit more, because at times you look like you're not enjoying it as much as you should. But other than that, I think you've definitely found where you should be.
Thank you. Thank you.
Lucy, this is the first time, for me, you have made yourself relevant as a pop artist. Because now the song and you are working, and this is where we've had a problem. It's all been a bit karaoke, a bit this, bit that. You looked comfortable. It's not a well-known song, but it's a good song. And I think, I actually agree with what Louis just said. I think you're now... Very good.
All I can add to that is I'm not the only person who loves Lucy. Yeah. Beautiful, beautiful performance.
All right, first kind of universal praise from the judges tonight. Makes a nice change. What do you think about that? Because Simon has sort of done a 180 on you in the last 2 weeks. He absolutely loves you now.
Thank you. That was really cool. I really enjoyed it. I like that song, and it's like it's cool, and it's like Disney. So it was fun, and I really enjoyed it, so thank you.
And you're turning into a little bit of a rock chick now, last week and this week?
I know. Like, can you imagine? Like, I was like, I will always love you. And now I'm doing like, yeah.
Excellent stuff. All right, 0901, 61, 105. Number to call to keep Lucy in this spotlight. Lines won't open until all the acts have performed, so contain yourselves until then. For now, it's Lucy Jones. All right, last of the overs now. Simon, tell us who it is.
We have a new Daniel Johnson.
It was sad to see you, like you've lost your mojo.
Pick yourself up and get back in the race, because that's life.
You are still, undoubtedly, the best singer still in the competition.
Daniel!
Saturday night wasn't my best night. I was just completely lost. I thought maybe I'm just going to give up.
It was out of tune throughout. Rachel came out and fought for her position. It's what you kind of needed to do tonight.
I thought that Danny and Cheryl were completely right. I thought I was going home.
Daniel!
When I got through on Sunday night, I just felt like I've been given a second chance by the public. What happened last week can never happen again.
Daniel last week, just his spirit had gone. We've had a long conversation and I think his confidence is back up again.
Getting the chance to go to a movie premiere was just a great way of just putting everything behind me. It's just amazing. Paparazzi people screaming your name, going, no, look this way, look this way, look this way.
I'm having the best time. I feel so lucky. It's amazing.
It makes you feel that you don't want this whole thing to end. This week is movie week. I'm singing the title song to a Prince film. It's just a fantastic song.
I chose this song because it's difficult and I love it. It's one of my favourite songs of all time.
This week, I really worked with him on getting his confidence back into the performance.
You've got to fight back.
There's a big chance. It's just going to go back to that overproduced performance.
I'm sure he's going to do a big, long note at the end, but I'm kind of over it.
He has to be amazing this week. Not good, amazing. It's about time this got back to being a singing competition.
Tonight, I really wanted to show that I haven't given up, and I really don't want to be in the bottom two again.
Never meant to cause you any sorrow. Never meant to cause you any pain. Only wanted to one time see you laughing. I only wanna see you laughing in the purple rain. Something real that means it to me. You say you wanna lead her, but you seem not to make up your mind. I think you better close it and let me guide you to the purple rain. Purple rain, to purple rain.
Tonight, you came out there and you absolutely won everybody over. It's very hard to sing, Prince. I love the falsetto bit. Daniel, you deserve to be in the competition. You are a talented guy. And if we're judging on vocal ability, you've got it all. I think you're going to be in the final.
Daniel, love the new look. Much, much better look. Very, very good. It was a really, really good performance.
I love the bit when you went into the falsetto at the end. I don't love it when you scream too much at the end. Your voice is very, very good, and you need to really, really use it. Don't scream too much, because okay. It doesn't do you justice.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Your demeanour tonight, Daniel, it's kind of like you've lost that cocky attitude you began with, yeah. But you're not the broken man we seen last week. There's somewhere in between.
That's what you asked for. Do you like the hair?
I like the hair. I love the hair.
I know I'm repeating myself, but I've just got to say this again because I do think it's important to take this into the context of the real world. That was an outstanding vocal.
It was. I mean, I've got to tell you,
I really, really mean this, is that I think this show has found a great, great singer who was almost broken, who's now got his confidence back up, and we should be proud of you, we should be supporting you, because I think you could go on to have a great career, and I'm very proud of you, Daniel. Well done.
Okay. I just want to pick up on something. Cheryl, I was fully prepared to come out here tonight and go to you, is there anything this guy can do to turn you around? Because like, I remember sort of being quite shocked when you said last week, just, I don't get it. But tonight he has done, right?
Yeah, I thought he delivered a really nice vocal and there was no cocky attitude there, which was lovely to see.
Like an hour ago, what have you done? Were you attacked?
Yeah, no, I just cut it all off. New beginning and everything.
That's how it is.
Yeah, I just want to start fresh.
Daniel, thank you very much. Best of luck. 0901 6161 106. Number to call. Move Daniel one step closer to that final. Don't call it now, though. Keep your fingers on hold. The line's open at the end of the show. For now, it's Daniel Johnson. After the break, and on this stage, it's twins time. John and his sequel, Edward. See you in a minute. Welcome back to The X Factor. It's movie night, starring our A-list audience. Best seats in town, but you can have that too. The X Factor tour takes off next year. The details you need available at itv.com/X Factor. Up next, the only group left in the competition, so we pay a visit to their mentor, the man with the looks of Brad Pitt, the body of Arnie, and the mind of Liza Minnelli, Mr. Louis Walsh.
It's the act that everybody is talking about, the funny, the fun fact is X Factor. It's John and Edward.
I felt like I was rocking to that song.
Out of tune.
They're energetic, entertaining.
John and Edward.
That last week we got to show a different side to us because everyone thought we just like these pop singers that always sing pop songs. We totally rocked it out and everyone comes up to me and goes, God, guys, you're a rock.
It was Night of the Living Dead.
It would feel weird if he said something nice to us because I'm like, where'd that go from? This week we had so much fun. We went to a movie premiere.
Everyone going crazy.
Twin Mania.
I never imagined being on a red carpet in our life.
Hey guys, I don't know who any of you guys are.
People have started to call us Jedward. It's cool because it's like Brangelina. I think some people write Jedward because it's shorter to write instead of having to go John and Edward.
I read Jedward.
We had to think John Fields, only a J's in there.
I think that John and Edward should enjoy their success. They get a bit of flack, but these guys should enjoy it.
These boys are stars. The morning after the premiere, it was only John and Edward in all the newspapers.
They're not entertaining the nation. Even the Prime Minister said they can't sing.
So Gordon Brown and Simon Cowell have something in common. Neither of them know what the public want. So this week is movie week, and I've picked the ultimate movie song, Ghostbusters.
When we were little, we always wanted to be Ghostbusters, but we weren't brave enough.
I'm afraid of no ghosts, but I'm starting to get afraid of John and Edward.
While we're singing, we have to focus on our dance routine and we have to stay in character. I don't think we'll be able to do it all at the same time.
Okay, you guys aren't focusing at all.
Their heads are just somewhere else all the time.
The truth is, it can't last much longer because it is a singing competition. They haven't sung a single song in tune yet.
Simon is terrified and I'm loving every minute of it.
John and Edward!
something constructive to say. It's a singing competition. You either talk or you rap. So I'm wondering what you will release if you win the competition. I love watching you guys perform. But I can't imagine listening to you on the radio.
I can.
I think, yeah. Do you know what? You bring fun to this show. Whether people like it or whether people don't, it's fun to watch. And it is. Ten, absolutely adore you, so good on you for getting up there.
Look, guys, I think we've established over the past few weeks that you can't sing. But this was actually a good song for you. Because actually, you did choose the right song for them, Louis, because based on some of the horrors we've seen before, this was sort of good.
In a very childish, average age of 1.5 enjoying things, I thought it was actually more entertaining than some of the kind of the karaoke stuff I saw before, so well done.
Guys, all I know is everywhere I go, people are talking about Jedward. And you know, you're two guys, every week you come out smiling and happy. I haven't had one problem with you. And the world is full of doom and gloom, and these boys are having fun. That's what this show is all about, fun.
I love the fact that Louis is using you as an antidote to the recession, which is wonderful. And you've got tonight as close as I think you're going to get from a compliment from Mr. Simon Cowell. How about that?
It's so cool that we come out here and normally it's like, oh, I would hate you. But like, there's a good comment, Simon. Thumbs up. Thanks.
Like, we really appreciate it. And you know, this would be possible without Brian Freeman and our creative team and everyone who helps with it.
Guys, I just want to find out from you guys, because you come out here and you get like booed, and Simon gives you a hard time, the judges give you a hard time. How do you feel every week? Every week you just keep coming back for more.
You just go for it. Like, we're young, just have fun, just go on stage. Like, it's a once in a lifetime opportunity, just do it.
And each week you say to me at the end of the Sunday show, you go, I can't believe we're still here. Do you honestly think you can get to the final? Do you think you can win this?
Honestly, you never know, is that all this week there's been so much hype, like Jedward to win and everything. We just want people to know that, like, I know there's all this massive hype about us. We want people to know that we still need their support and like, because we're not safe. You know what I mean?
We're real grateful for all their support, because only for them we wouldn't be here.
Okay, guys, thanks, sir. 0901 61 61 107. Don't call Ghostbusters. Call that number if you want to see John and Edward doing their thing on this stage next week. Wait till lines open at the end of the show. Here's John, here's Edward. Together they are John and Edward. This is not what I signed up for. Not long to go now. After the break, lines are going to be opening for your votes. And closing the show tonight, Geordie Joe will be right here. And we'll be right back. Welcome back to The X Factor. It has been a cracking movie night, hasn't it? Lions due to open very soon, but not before tonight's final actors hit the stage. Last of the boys, Cheryl, tell us who it is.
Last up, but certainly not least, it's my gorgeous Geordie boy, Joe McKelvey. It's exceptional.
It was a little bit limp and stage scrawly and hard.
Last week was amazing. I was actually in the audience. It felt like I had my own concert.
It's just brilliant.
I thought last week for Joe, everything clicked into place and he's sparkling up there.
Getting to go to the premiere of A Christmas Carol was absolutely incredible. I remember standing in front of the photographers and I could see all these flashes just flashing everywhere. It was just like being an A-list celebrity. I was thinking to myself, how am I standing on here? Why me? I just couldn't believe that I was there.
Feels like a dream has come true, and this is the dream.
The whole thing just felt like one massive dream that I never want to wake up from.
I've chosen Joe a really beautiful, epic sounding song from one of my favourite Disney films.
I love The Lion King. It always reminds us of being a child. It's one of those films you can just watch over and over again. And I remember as a child watching it with my mum. It's a really uplifting film.
This song is from a movie, but it's more famous for being from a musical. And if it's not good tonight, this could be a nightmare.
He's a musical theatre singer, so we'll have every gimmick in the world thrown at it. But that's what I expected.
They can all sit there saying, Joe's musical theatre. It's because he's strong, he's powerful, and that's how he delivers a song.
I want to be a pop star, and tonight I'm going to go out there and show everybody that that's exactly what I can do.
From the day we arrived on the planet, and the blinking step into the sun, there is more to see than can never be seen, more to do than can never be done. There is far too much to take in here, more to find than can never be found. But the sun rolling high through the sapphire sky keeps waiting small on the endless round in the circle of life.
And you tick all the boxes, but as Simon said on the VT, I do think you're more musical theatre than pop star, and we are looking for a pop star. And I think the song, Cheryl, I think it was a little bit predictable and a little bit safe. I think you are better. I think you've got a lot more potential than that.
Coming from you, John and Edward, you're looking for a pop star.
Yeah, but they're fun.
The best male vocalist in the competition, hands down. You're the most likeable, you're the most beautiful guy. The only thing I would critique is your voice is strong, and that's what musical theatre is, but I didn't like the production on this song because it was like Les Mis mixed with Lion King, and I didn't really get it. I love it when you just perform a song, and I think that was detracting from you.
Okay.
Joe, I thought it was a perfect song for you, this. I really genuinely did. It's what you're all about. I actually liked the production. The only thing I didn't like is the fact that you've got to stop this kind of stage school swaying, which, you know, you've got to have the confidence to take the mic, believe in yourself. I don't think you're the best male singer in the competition. Having said that, I think you're commercial, I think you know who you are, and I think you should enjoy this moment. That was very good.
I just love you, Joe. Every week,
I love working with you even more. I get to know you. You're starting to feel like a little brother to me, and it's just so proud to watch you up there singing like that. It's absolutely amazing.
Nice stuff. Thank you very much, Cheryl. What do you think about those comments? Because, I mean, to be fair, Louis, he does Journey last week. He does a, you know, something for like...
I like
for me, he's a well-rounded pop star.
Yeah, but you're not a judge, Dermot. I'm a judge. You're not a judge. I'm a judge.
Louis,
you're
just a humble member of the public expressing my opinion, sticking up for the act.
You're not a judge. I'm a judge. You're a presenter.
Well, to be fair, I think the public are the real judges, aren't they? Mate, how do you feel about that?
I enjoyed the song and... It is a musical theatre song, so it is going to be hard to make it into a pop song, but I try my best, and hopefully everyone like that.
Thank you very much. Simon, very briefly, I've got to go to the numbers.
I just want to say to Louis, you've insulted our Prime Minister tonight, you've insulted the public. I think you should apologise.
To who? No, I'm not apologising.
No. Simon, we're above it. 0901 61 61 108. A call to that number will keep a big grin on this guy's face. Lines will be opening very, very soon. Of course, got 35p from a BT landline from other networks, maybe higher from mobiles, we'll be considering more. This is Joe McKeldry. All right, this is it. Vote is now open and will close in tomorrow night's results show. Sky and Virgin Media viewers can vote using your red buttons. Vote cast after lines are closed won't be counted but may still be charged. The acts have come a long way. None of them now want to go home, but dial carefully. Just a number separating the acts. So, the vote for Stacey, number to call. 0901 61 61 101. If Ollie was your favourite, add 02. If you like Lloyd, you need to add 03. To give Jamie a vote for 04 in the end. If you want Lucy to stay, add 05. It's 06 on the end for Daniel. If John and Edward did it for you, stick 07 on the end. Add 08 to vote for Joe. No one is safe. No one can be certain of a place in next week's show. Here's a reminder of all of tonight's live performances and the numbers you need. You have 24 hours and counting before another act will leave the competition. Your votes decide who survives the fight on and who's going to be heading home. They are relying on you. All will be revealed tomorrow night. Plus, the Flown from America, one of the biggest bands on the planet. The Black Eyed Peas are here. and she is a homegrown superstar, a world-class diva, and it all started right here. She's coming home. Leona Lewis! All right, for exclusive videos, go to itv.com/X Factor. If you've got an opinion, switch over to ITV2 and The Extra Factor, where the judges are going to be taking your calls. We're going to see you 8 o'clock tomorrow night, ITV1. See you then.
If you're wondering what they've been up to in the house, see them all having a crack at karaoke on the website. What will Simon say?
You knew for over a year that Ronnie was planning to retire.
He really had tears in his eyes, and so did I, because he knew he would never come back in here again.
And as Dermot said, Leona Lewis is on The X Factor tomorrow. Her new video exclusive is after Piers Morgan's life stories, next.